dreams come true. Hey, money make your dreams come true. Hey, money make your dreams come true. That money make your dreams come true.
XRO.
Larry Fridie, how are you?
Well, I'm fine, I'm fine. Just glad to be here, glad to be here.
Awesome. So can you tell me what you think about the whole experience? Since this is your first time out, you're getting to listen to some new artists from XRO Studios. Tell me about how you feeling them.
Well, I tell you, you know, I travel all over the world. I've been to studios in Europe, Asia, Africa, and I really enjoy to hear XRO Studios. The sound that they created for their artists is definitely state of the art, and it's definitely at a level that's sellable.
Now, did you ever think that you would come to a studio out here in South Carolina and kind of just get that sound that you have it, that you didn't expect?
No, I didn't expect this out here. As a matter of fact, I wish James Brown was still alive and I would bring him out here and we would record with him out here. It's that good, state of the art.
Nice and exclusive. Mm-hmm. Okay, so you've told me behind the scenes who you've worked with. Now, for the people that don't know who Larry Fridie has worked with, your business management, you've worked with everybody from James Brown, Mariah Carey. I'm going to let you tell your story.
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm.
Who else have you worked with?
Yeah, well, work with a lot of artists. Stevie Wonder, Mariah, Third Eye Blind, Lady Antebellum, James Brown, the Michael Jacksons. A lot of people call me for contractual work, but I was James Brown's manager for 12 years.
Nice. Mm-hmm. So going from a singer like him to some of the artists now, what are you looking forward to? And are you looking for a different sound, or how do you feel like the sound is going now?
Well, no, first of all, Pompey, who's one of the producers here, engineers here, he's a great friend of mine. He's kind of like an understudy. And so, you know, I came out here pursuant to his invitation. And Pompey is really, really good. I mean, I started with Pompey about 5 years ago when he trained at Tree Sound Studios in Atlanta.
Okay.
Which is probably one of the top five studios in the world.
Right. Okay.
And so to have Pompey out here and to meet the gentleman, you know, out here, I mean, this is really booming. It's going to be a big, big... So I suggest anybody who wants to record, come to XRO Studios.
Nice. So what kind of advice can you give artists looking to start in the game? You know, some people are just saying social media, but you were before that social media era. Mm-hmm. Like, how could you tell them, like, direct them in the way to go since you've known with and without social media?
Right. Just got to study the business. You got to know the business. You got to know who your target audience is. You got to know the package that you're trying to bring. The recording, that's another thing I found out about XRO Studios. They are not only a recording studio, but they do videos. They package you as an artist. And that's the most important thing, because when you walk into a label and you say, I got a good song, well, what's next?
Right, right.
You know, and that's the package that they have to understand right now. If you know your target audience is going to be hip-hop, they're going to be 11 to 18-year-olds, you got to know what's working right now and get your music that's ahead of the game, trendy.
Right.
Not be current. It's not good to be current, because current's going to wear out in 3 months.
Now, you got their advice. What else could you give them as far as, like, the connections, like networking? Because some people don't know how to do that. Some people just stuck behind the social media. Now, what advice can you give them as well as to getting out there? Like, hey, you have to mix and mingle with some of the people. Because some people just think that their social media fame is going to get them somewhere. Mm-hmm. And it doesn't equal money at all. Mm-hmm. So, in your opinion?
Well, I guess in my opinion, what young artists or upcoming artists need is the good team. You know, you need a person that understands public relations, that understands marketing, that understands recording, understand putting on a live show.
Right.
You put that team together, you trust in them, and you go forward. I mean, social media is going to work on its own.
Okay.
Once you're released, if the record is good, it's going to go viral, which means it has legs of its own self. So you might see a video from a group out of, just say, Atlanta or Augusta, that has a dance studio. And you look down there, they have 20 million views. It's because that content, somebody said, wow, did you see that dance over there? Mm-hmm. And they told somebody about it. So when you're making your music, when you're developing your persona, you have to make it so that people will say, wow, did you see that person?
Right.
And as a new artist, I mean, there's nothing really you can do that hadn't already been done. You just got to take it and make it yours, whatever you want to do.
Now, what's some of the best advice maybe James Brown is giving you in music general, or life general?
And
give us a little tidbit of what James Brown gave to you.
Well, you know, I was on the business side with, okay, with James Brown. And so basically on the business side, you got to know the business, the music business. You got to know what's working. You got to know who's working. You got to know contractual relationships. You got to know music publishing. 99% of the artists out here don't understand music publishing. Mm-hmm. Music publishing is your money for your life and your kids' life and your grandkids' life. So if you create a record today, it's good for life and being plus 70 years. You got to know all that. So when you're recording, when you're talking about, I want to get my royalties, you got to know what you're talking about and how to count it. It's a global world out here, you know. And so right now, well, James Brown, when he started in 1961, his music was only sold on the East Coast, and it was sold the 13 states on the East Coast. Now a kid, let's say Dank, the kid here that we heard. By the way, Dank is a great artist. His record can be released in 200 countries worldwide.
Oh, nice.
So you got to have somebody who understands the paperwork that's going to come behind those 200. Because right now, CD Baby, you can put your record out yourself and it goes worldwide. Mm-hmm. Is it protected? When are your royalties due? How much royalties do you expect? And when to move on? The biggest question an artist has to know is, when is a record stopped? When is it no longer good? Move on to the next record.
Okay.
And when to hold back? Because the record is working. So it's a lot to the game. You just got to have a good team.
XRO.